Hey, what's up, guys? It's Kodak. Today we're talking about the Xtar SP100 solar panel. I've broken this review down into a few different sections. We'll start with an unboxing and my initial impressions, and then I'll kind of talk about the panel itself, the features, the specs, what I like, what I don't like, and how it compares to some other panels on the market. So first thoughts on the solar panel. It seems super high quality. It has a really satisfying, strong magnetic click to it and takes some force to pull them apart. And yeah, I don't know. It just seems like high quality all around. Has a real nice finish, a dimpled finish here to help catch the sun. All the stitchings, the seams all seem really well done. They use a nice weather sealed zipper on the back here. Cable. It could be longer, but I'm kind of used to short cables anyway. That's the way Goal Zero and most of them do it. It actually makes the panels more efficient if you don't have a long cable, and then you can always hook an adapter into it. One disappointment right off the bat is that you need an adapter for this to work with Goal Zero. I didn't realize that when I got it. You see the difference that Goal Zero uses this like tapered end here, and they have a weathered seal gasket to it, but it doesn't come included with this adapter. It has some MC4 connectors. I had another little adapter for some of the other batteries, but it worked out okay for me because I needed a splitter anyway so that I can plug this and my Goal Zero panel into the 500X. Yeah, I like it. I'm really excited to use it. Seems really nice. The SP100 is actually a 120 watt solar panel. So far, this panel's been like performing really well. I was actually kind of shocked at the results I'm getting from it. Compared to my Boulder 100, this thing is like outperforming it by a good bit. I'm getting like consistently over 100 watts on this compared to my Boulder panel. I get around 90, it kind of tops out. I am using a splitter though, and that's what's great, is being able to like connect two panels into my Goal Zero battery banks, both of which top out at one at 100 watt input and the other one at 150 watts. So I couldn't even really take full advantage of these panels as it is, chaining them together, but it still helps a lot and helps keep me moving and powered out here. Most panels out there are like in the 100 watt range, and no panel is 100% efficient, so they'll mostly put out like 90% of their actual power. But this panel is topping out around like 115 watts. I've never seen a panel like fully peak out, but then you can see they tend to get pretty dusty and dirty and stuff out here, and I'm not the best at keeping them clean. As you can see, I've had this one now for about 2 or 3 weeks, and yeah, it's seen quite a bit of use. What I'm really curious to know is how the surface lasts, if it'll get scratched up from just being like folded and closed up and stuffed in the trunk. I think the best way to store this panel would be to like keep a layer of like cardboard or something in there to help keep it from rubbing together. Something soft like a bubble wrap would probably be the best. I've just been folding it and sticking it in there to kind of more or less test the durability of it. They use some sort of, I don't know, like ethylene coating on it. So it has like a, almost like a rubbery, plasticky kind of feel to it. It seems like it'll be pretty durable and scratch resistant. I know some of the Goal Zero Nomad panels, like they're like tend to scratch. I scratched some of the smaller ones, like the Nomad 28, just from them being folded and getting all that rust, all the dust and the rocks and stuff in there. But yeah, this one seems to be holding up fine so far. It is quite dusty as you can see, but all of that comes right off pretty well. This company does use SunPower solar cells, which are known to be the industry leader. I don't know a ton about the specifics there, but like SunPower cells are the industry leader. They're known to be one of the best, so it's nice that they are putting them here on their solar panels. They are 23% efficient, which is, yeah, pretty similar now across the board. Most of these are pretty standard. I really like how small it is. Like, this thing is tiny, and compared to my Boulder 100, like, man, it takes up so much little room, and it like really outperforms it, so that's pretty incredible. I'm like actually really impressed with this solar panel, and if I could do it all over again, I would just buy two of these. And they're also cheaper than the Goal Zero panel or a lot of the other solar panels, really. At like, I think they're selling right now for like $269, and they sent me a code, so if you use that code in the link, you'll get an extra like $30 off like the standard panel, and then if you order it with some of the bundles, you'll get even more money off. That code is Ryan30. It's linked in the description below, so I appreciate it. It helps me out if you use it, but it also helps you guys. It'll save you $30 on this panel. Yeah, it seems really well constructed. It's just like a nice bifold stone stitch design here. The cable is, it's 3 meters, it's 10 foot long. It's a little longer than the Goal Zero panels, which are 6 foot, so that's nice. They also use like a thicker, heavier gauge wire on it. I don't know how much of a difference that actually makes. I am bummed, as I mentioned, that it doesn't plug directly into it, but the adapter I bought does come with a fitting for it, so it will plug into the Goal Zero that way. If you don't have Goal Zero, it doesn't matter so much. And it also comes with MC4 and I believe a DC 5525 connector, so it'll plug into things like Rock Pals and some of the other panels out there. You could also get an adapter to send it to Anderson if you have like Anderson plugs or connectors there. An extension cable for this is really nice. I have the Goal Zero one, it adds about 15 foot to it. So especially with the splitter on these, that gets me a couple more foot there too. But it's also really nice because on this one, you can't change the adapter or you can't change the wire. So if that breaks, you're kind of screwed. So like being able to plug this in there and then I can just shut my van door and close it on this adapter cable. And there's definitely some like chinks and nicks in this cable here from having that door closed on it all the time. So it's nice being able to just like beat this thing up and you can see where it's starting to fray. I mean, some electrical tape would fix that up just fine, but like, yeah, it's nice because the cable on this is not replaceable. So if you do damage it or you damage the connector here where it hooks into the panel, you're gonna have to just like replace the entire panel for it. I was a little worried on a panel like this that it would blow away. That's one of the big problems I had with the Goal Zero Nomad panels. If I left them sit out in high wind, they would collapse or actually get like kind of blown. So I would end up having to clip shoes or like water bottles, just clip anything to them to keep them in place. But this one, being that it is 10 pounds and that it goes pretty low here for the adjustability, like I've used it in some pretty strong winds and haven't had an issue. It's like stood its ground pretty well. I probably wouldn't leave it this upright, but when it's like laying back pretty good, like it would take a lot of wind to like fully collapse this thing. So I'm not worried about it, and it's definitely not gonna actually go anywhere. It just might get knocked over if the wind was strong enough. There's a lot of companies offering solar panels like this now. I believe that Jackery was actually the first with their Solar Saga 100. That is a 100 watt panel, and this is a 120 watt panel. So this is gonna be a little more bang for your buck, and it's also cheaper than the Jackery. But I've seen a number of other competitors all making like this exact same design. The price on this really sells it. The size being 10 pounds. I already mentioned that like magnetic closure to it. That is a really nice feature. It has a nice pocket here on the back for just like storing and tucking away the cable and the different adapters for it. And yeah, other than that, it's pretty easy. Pretty nice panel. Woo! All right, I'm calling that done. All right, yeah, I'm a weirdo, guys. See ya. I stole our dinner table to film this review. Time for dinner.